From my 4 years at Galena High School, I have learned so much from friends. I learned that your friends are always going to be there, and they're very important. My best memories are the football games, the basketball games, the partying. I'm looking forward to moving away and learning new things from other people. I'm definitely going to miss my friends. Going to miss all the memories we've made with each other. Galena's contributed a lot to my life. All my best friends I've met here and everyone that's a big part of my life is at Galena.
As you're going through forging that path, remember the one most important tool is your tennis shoes.
Galena has made my life really interesting. My experiences at Galena have contributed to my life because they've helped make who I am. They have shaped my life.
Leave the kids alone. You're acting Andy, did you hear it? this one. Tell me, are you locked in the pond? Andy, are you goofing on Elvis?
Hey, baby, are we losing touch?
If you believe they put a man on the moon, man on the moon. If you believe there's nothing up their sleeve, nothing is
thank you. difficult to say goodbye after only one life. And rain will fall down, replenishing all of our broken dreams. And this burning tree that's withering will bloom again. Would you believe? Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's hard to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's time to say.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Will you please stand for the procession of the Galena High School graduating class of 2000. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the Galena High School graduating class of the year 2000. Will you please remain standing for the presentation of our national colors by the Galena High School JROTC Color Guard under the direction of retiring Sergeant Major John Sharon, and our national anthem sung this evening by the Galena High School Concert Choir under the direction of Mr. Andy Sonnemaker. Music tonight from the rendition of the musical play Cats entitled Memories is performed by our string ensemble by Rachel Jersey, Shanam Farahi, Terlaine Downs, and Melissa Hopkins.
Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ross Gregory, and as the principal of Galena High School, I would like to take this opportunity to welcome each of you to the graduation ceremony for Galena High School's graduating class of the year 2000. Please allow me to introduce the adults, the guests, the students, and the faculty members who are seated on our stage this evening. To my right and your left in the first row, and I hope I can see this because we've changed a little bit of order tonight, our school board president, school board of trustees, Mrs. Ann Loring. School board member, Mr. Bob Bentley. School board clerk, Mrs. Nancy Hollinger. School board member, Mrs. Marilyn Findelander. School board vice president and a parent of a Galena graduate 5 years ago and a great supporter to Galena High School, Mrs. Dorothy Dermody. And school board member, Mrs. Leslie Porter. In the second row, Assistant Superintendent, Mr. Paul Dugan. Area Assistant Superintendent, Mr. Ken Green. Superintendent of the Washoe County School District, Dr. James Hager. The Area Assistant Superintendent for Galena High School, Area 3, Assistant Superintendent, Mrs. Debbie Silkey. And Deputy Superintendent, Dr. James Welch. And in the back row is our administrative team at Galena High School, Mr. Don Reynolds, Mr. Darrell Wright, Mrs. Denise Haushauer. To my left and your right, we have several students that are seated on the stage with us tonight, and they will receive a special introduction in just a few moments. But in the back row, in this side of the stage, we have our two senior class advisors, Mrs. Janine Pasek and Mrs. Yvette Dayton. And our faculty readers for our graduates tonight, Mr. John Linton, Mrs. Nancy Greenwald, Miss Colleen Hope, Mrs. Teresa Lindsay. And I would also like those faculty and staff members who are here this evening seated right behind our graduates to please stand for a few moments that you might be recognized. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great honor to introduce a great student and a great friend, the president of our senior class and mistress of ceremonies this evening, Miss Megan Lund.
Stage to your right, we have our three valedictorians, Lisa Kapczynski, Chris Martindale, and Dan Hickman. Our salutatorian, Andy Sweat. And speaking tonight, we have Alexa Scott and Michael Ames. And Michael is also one of our senior class officers. The rest of our senior class officers are also on the stand tonight. Elizabeth England, Michelle Rands, Andrew Abrams, and Jared Singleton. Thank you. I I am so excited to be standing before all of you tonight. Parents, family, friends, and of course all the graduates sitting before me. Before I say anything else, I want to take the time to thank some important people who have helped this class reach this point and who assisted myself and the other class officers in fulfilling our duties. Mr. Gregory, Ms. Pasek, Ms. Dayton, Ms. Greenhall, the graduation committee, and of course my own parents and the parents of the other class officers. Without the love and support you've given us, nothing would have pulled together these past 4 years. We all appreciate you so much. And to my own mom and dad, I love you. From the first time this class entered the halls of Galena High School, we always knew we were better than any other class. Even as awkward freshmen, as we stared in awe at the enormous facial hair-bearing seniors, the freshman boys assured us that one day they too would be these macho men. Sure enough, we have plenty of burly senior males and beautiful, sophisticated young women with us tonight. Our class has developed, and I'm not just referring to physically. We have united to form a true class full of wonderful, unique people. It has taken time, but the separate cliques formed our freshman and sophomore years have meshed together this year, bringing us all together as one true class. As we are about to start on this new journey, remember the success we have had the past 13 years of our educational career. Some will be continuing on for more books, classes, and tests. Others will not. But whatever any of you do, remember that all of us have the potential to reach what it is that we're striving for. At times, we may get discouraged, and we may not succeed right off. But as the saying goes, our greatest glory is not in never falling, but in rising every time we fall. Now is the time for us to get up and rise to meet our new challenges. Class of 2000, tonight is our night to make our mark in history. We, being the class of the new millennium, have the future in our hands, and we have the talent and determination to make it is whatever that we want to make it. Congratulations. Next, we'll be hearing from our salutatorian, Andy Sweat, followed by a musical number entitled What I Did for Love by Marcello Shoto, Cassia Chevalon, and Christy Carew.
The male-to-female ratio at the college a friend of mine attends is 8-1. Being in the unfortunate majority, he keeps his eyes open for any opportunity to meet young women. One day, he looked at the bulletin board announcements and did a double take. A sign read, "One night stand, $20. Wow, he thought. But his excitement was short-lived. Written below in smaller print was, "Sorry guys, I'm only selling furniture." Here to celebrate Galena's class of 2000, students who will surely be leaders as we move into the new millennium. After tonight's rite of passage, we all get to pretend to be adults. You may feel like you have more freedom, but this newfound freedom brings responsibility. When it comes to success, I believe it's not how much you know, but how you live life. With this in mind, let me share the following perspectives. What matters is not the size of the dog in the fight, but the size of the fight in the dog. Say thank you, a lot. Admit your mistakes. Ignore those people who discourage you. Become who you are. Thoughts become actions. Actions become habits. Habits become character. Character becomes destiny. Don't flush the urinal with your hand, use your elbow. Before you criticize someone, you should walk a mile in their shoes. That way, when you criticize them, you're a mile away and you have the shoes. Be a good loser. Be a good winner. Good judgment comes from bad experience, and a lot of that comes from bad judgment. Be willing to lose a battle in order to win the war. When your opponent is bigger, stronger, faster, train harder, longer, smarter. Don't be called out on strikes. Go down swinging. There are two theories to arguing with girls. Neither one works. Be bold and courageous. When you look back on your life, you'll regret the things you didn't do more than the ones you did. You've got to stand for something, or you'll fall for anything. Generally speaking, you aren't learning much when your mouth is open. On the flip side, never miss a good chance to shut up. You are what you eat, so stay away from the jerk chicken. Try something new. Remember, amateurs built the Ark, professionals built the Titanic. Your parents are smarter than you give them credit for. Keep your words soft and sweet, just in case you have to eat them. When you were born, you cried and the world rejoiced. Live your life so that when you die, the world cries and you rejoice. To all the parents out there, especially my dad and my mamacita, I'd like to say thanks for the sacrifices you've made over the years. Monica Miles, you deserve to be recognized for your outstanding academic achievements. I wish you were up here giving this speech with me. And to the class of 2000, I hope you will accept my challenge to use your abilities and gifts to reach your highest potential. Take the time to educate your heart, cultivate your soul, and look for the extraordinary in the ordinary. For us, the end is really only the beginning. So dream big and enjoy the ride. Thank you.
Michael Ames, entitled Success, and following him, we will hear from Alexis Scott with The Way You Look Tonight.
Good evening. Our greatest successes accompany challenges. We are taught in many ways, but it has been shown that education is the key to success. Being taught what to do and how to do it will certainly help us become more successful. But truly, our greatest lessons come from making mistakes. Vernon Law once said, "Experience is a tough teacher. She gives you the test first, the lesson later." Just like the baby that falls down before learning to walk, we can only be shown the path. There is a difference between knowing the path and walking the path. Success can be difficult to achieve. Many lessons have to be learned before any one of us can truly achieve success. Education is just a way of preparing one for the challenges that lie ahead, but it will not teach you all you need to know. There is so much information in the world, and too little time for teachers to teach us everything. They can only teach us how to learn. Gloria Steinem stated, "An education is not a thing one gets, but a lifelong process." Time and experience teaches the lessons of life, while education softens the blow. Many of us cried when we fell, but that did not stop us from learning to walk. We need to understand that falling is part of the learning process. Getting back up and trying again is that portion of the lesson that education supports. Making mistakes is a part of life. Success arrives when we learn from those mistakes. Making a mistake once is all right. Making the same mistake over and over means you are not moving forward. Therefore, achievement, or moving forward, is synonymous with success. Our greatest successes come not in never falling, but in getting up every time that we fall. To my friend John, we missed you this year. And to my parents and friends, I love you all. Good night.
As I stand before you, I can't help but think of the famous words sung by Elton John. On this night, I can't explain it, but there is something about the way you look tonight. It takes my breath away. That feeling I get about you, Galena, deep inside, I can't describe. In all honesty, I'm speechless, and I don't know where to start. But there is something about the way you look tonight. Congratulations, we made it and accomplished a goal so many dream about. I'm sure that many of the graduates right now are thinking, free at last, free at last. God Almighty, I'm free at last. But before we are free and we set out on our new journeys, we get to celebrate all the superior accomplishments of what I believe is the greatest class to ever roam the halls of Galena. Throughout high school, and since we were born, we've been dubbed as Generation X. It wasn't until a few months ago that I finally realized why we've been given that title. You see, in math, X stands for the unknown. People have labeled us Generation X because they are unsure of our outcome and what the future will bring. The funny and ironic part of this is that we do know what the future will bring. We do know the outcome. is inevitable that only great things are to come in the next years. Among us are the leaders of America, the next Tiger Woods, a Wimbledon champion, NFL, Major League, NBA, and WNBA superstars, Academy Award winners, top-selling musicians, best-selling authors, and Nobel Prize winner, teachers, lawyers, doctors, engineers, a marine biologist, husbands, wives, parents, and who knows, with the help of Mr. Linton, of course, a president of the United States. We are the class of 2000. We are the future. We are the gateway into the millennium. Tonight marks the beginning of our lives to come. At this moment, we should take the opportunity to remember the past years at Galena, whether they be good, bad, horrible even, or the best experiences of your life. Ranging from dances, parties, acing that test you didn't study for, sporting events, winning a competition, conferences, clubs, camping, choir, bands, plays, student council, the time your team brought home a zone or state title. Great time spent with friends, having boyfriends or girlfriends or the lack thereof. Mr. Gregory's great speeches that will surely be missed. And assemblies where you got to have fun with your friends. Or even make a fool out of yourself and fall in front of 1,600 people. Everyone has their favorite memory, and the list can go on and on. But tonight, that chapter in our book of life ends, and we begin a new one. As I end tonight, I would like to leave you with one thought. Some people come into our lives and go quickly. Some people move our souls to dance. They awaken us to new understanding with the passing whisper of their wisdom. Some people make the sky more beautiful to gaze upon. They stay in our lives for a while, leave footprints on our hearts, and we are never, ever the same. With that in mind, I think it would only be appropriate to thank the people that help us get to this night. Not only is it a celebration for us, but for them as well. The impact that teachers, counselors, administration, coaches, advisors, and others at Galena have had on our lives is immeasurable. Also, our parents, loved ones, and guardians' love and support has most definitely eased the pain of being a teenager. I would also like to give a personal thank you to my dad and mom, whose wisdom, encouragement, and love will never be forgotten. If I turn out to be half the person they are, I know I have truly succeeded. Also, to Ronnie Ann, Annalie, and Nicholas James Scott, who make each day of my life worth living. Thank you all for what you have given us. If we can now rise and give them, along with ourselves, a round of applause, for we are the class of 2000, we are the future, we are the gateway into the millennium.
Solo From Now On, composed and performed by Christy Carew. After that, our valedictorians Dan Hickman, Lisa Kapczynski, and Chris Martindale will give a speech on success throughout life, followed by our senior memories video.
Thank you.
Class of 2000. Success is an elusive concept. I have three reflections to share with you. One, we are not our own measure of success. Eternal standards exist. Two, success in the past does not guarantee success in the future. Three, success is an outward sign. More important are eternal values. Albert Einstein admonished, "Don't merely become a person of success, but become a person of value. What are your values?" Samuel, an ancient Hebrew prophet, astutely cautioned, "People judge by outward appearances, but the Lord looks at a person's thoughts and intentions." As you examine your past successes, as you determine what your future successes will be, remember Albert and Samuel and your values. Thank you.
We sit here today with dreams for the future and memories from the past, but it is the present in which we are perceived as being successful or not. What makes a person successful? Is it how much money they make or what grades they get? Or is it something as simple as how happy they are? It could be argued that if you are happy with your life, then you should indeed be considered successful. But who determines whether a person is successful or not? The looking glass through which success is perceived should be a mirror. Being successful in your own eyes is the most important and also the most difficult thing, for you cannot fool yourself as you might fool others. So if we can determine for ourselves whether we are successful in life or not, then each of us should be content tonight, for we have achieved something great. But what about tomorrow, or next week? How will you see yourself then? It is important to live in the present and not rest on past success or wait for the future. Every instant of your life, you should consider yourself a success. Not for what you have done in the past or for what you will do in the future, but for who you are and what you are at that moment. But we were not alone in getting here today, as we are not alone in perceiving how successful we are. Therefore, we must give thanks to our teachers, our coaches, our families, our friends, and the countless others who have helped bring us to our present success. To these people, we say, thank you for all that you have done for us in the past. Thank you for all that you will do for us in the future. And perhaps most importantly, thank you for all that you've helped us to become in the present. Thank you.
If we could see into the future, what would we do to achieve success? We must look beyond today to plan for tomorrow. You must decide what success will mean for you. It might be having wealth, fame, power, or friends. People seek these because they believe these things will make them happy, but no one knows for sure whether achieving these things will truly make them happy. You've heard the saying, the decisions you make today will affect your tomorrows. What does that mean? Does it mean just the big things, or do the little things count too? Does it mean seeking further education, such as going to college or joining the workforce? Right away. Does it mean getting married now or starting a family or waiting until you've completed other goals which you have set for yourself? What are the little things that could affect your future? Can you really drive those 2 miles home even though you've been drinking? Or should you give someone else the keys? Will I hurt myself if I jump off this cliff, or will it just be a cheap thrill? Consider the decisions you make today, even the small ones. They are what will shape your life. People may tell you you can't do something or that you don't deserve it, but you are the one who is now responsible for your future. You've waited 18 years to be in the driver's seat of your life. Your future starts tomorrow. Remember, you can't change your future once it has become your past, so live your life so you have no regrets. Thanks.
For my 4 years at Galena High School, I have learned so much from friends. I learned that your friends are always going to be there, and they're very important. My best memories are the football games, basketball games, the partying. I'm looking forward to moving away and learning new things from other people. I'm definitely going to miss my friends, going to miss all the memories we've made with each other. Galena has contributed a lot to my life. All my best friends I've met here and everyone that's a big part of my life is at Galena.
As you're going through forging that path, remember the one most important tool you need to keep with you in your bag of tools is your tennis shoes.
Galena made my life really interesting. Experiences at Galena have contributed to my life because they've helped make who I am. They have shaped my life.
You're acting like a child, but you're looking for the perfect time to leave. Finishing. Oh, looking in this bedroom that's withering, will bloom again. Would you believe? Goodbye, good God. Walk away, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's time to say goodbye. Goodbye, goodbye. Walk away, it's time to say goodbye. 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 Walk away. It's time to say goodbye.
I think that was my baby picture on the screen, and one of the members of my family are going to be in big trouble tonight when I get home. I would be remiss tonight if I did not recognize a unique and talented individual who makes a tremendous difference in the lives of many of our students, not only at Galena High School, but throughout the entire Washoe County School District. Galena High School has the distinction of housing the district's video broadcasting program at Galena High School. And the instructor for that program, Mrs. Robin Tanner, unselfishly gives of her time, her talents, and her energies so that the kind of production that we have just seen here this evening is not only made on behalf of our students, but other students at other schools throughout the district. The other night, as I was leaving our campus at 11:30 p.m. after a very long day, Mrs. Tanner was still in the lab, and I learned that she was there until about 1 a.m. putting together this senior video. Mrs. Tanner. Mrs. Tanner, and I know the spotlight probably won't hit her. She was directly down the center aisle with a set of headphones on. If you would please stand for a moment that we might recognize who you are and your tremendous talents and skills. Superintendent Dr. Hager, Deputy Superintendent Dr. Welch, President Ann Loring, and members of the Washoe County Board of Trustees, it gives me distinct privilege this evening as the principal of Galena High School to present to you this evening an outstanding group of young men and women who have achieved the necessary requirements to receive their high school diplomas from Galena High School in this new millennium. I am extremely proud to present this evening a group of very dedicated, responsible, hardworking, and very talented group of young men and women who have completed the necessary requirements to receive their high school diplomas. The members of this class have achieved so many exceptional achievements and accomplishments during their 4 years of high school that it would take considerable time this evening to enumerate each and every one of those. However, I do need to highlight a few of the class and individual accomplishments in athletics, extracurricular programs, and academic achievements during their past 4 years. Members of this graduating class tonight have participated on several divisional, zone, and state-winning athletic teams, not only in the past, but including this year, to include the Northern Nevada 4A Girls Soccer Zone Champions, the Girls Golf Zone Champions, the Boys Wrestling Team Zone Champions, the Girls Skiing State Champions, and for the first time in the history of Galena High School, the Girls Basketball State Championship. Additionally, one of our seniors this evening, Travis Wisman, holds... I will wait because this is important, and these young men and women have achieved some tremendous successes, and I would ask those of you in the audience tonight to please show the respect that is due to them by holding those kind of noises and sounds. Additionally, one of our seniors, Travis Wisman, holds two consecutive Nevada State Men's Golf Championships. Dozens of students and programs have received several awards and honors, including the Washoe County School District JROTC Top Battalion Program for the fourth consecutive year in a row, and named the Honor Unit with Distinction for four consecutive years as the top ROTC program out of 135 schools in the western portion of the United States. Members of this class have received several academic, music, art, writing, journalism, speech and debate, business and vocational awards and honors, including qualifying for both state, local, and national competition. Two students this evening have qualified to attend the National Speech and Debate Tournament this summer, Ben Johnson and Marcella Shoto. And during this last month, Marcella Shoto was named as Nevada Junior Miss and will be competing at the national pageant later this month. Tonight, we are recognizing and presenting diplomas to 332 graduating seniors, 184 girls, 148 boys. Three of our graduates are graduating a year ahead of their academic classes, juniors. 96 of our graduates are being recognized tonight as honor diploma recipients. 54 of our graduates are being recognized tonight as Nevada High School Scholars. 12 graduating seniors have received the distinction as a U.S. Presidential Scholar. We have one salutatorian and three valedictorians with cumulative grade point average, including minuses for four consecutive years, of a perfect 4.0 GPA. We have one U.S. Naval Academy appointee. And we have one National Merit Scholarship and one graduating principal tonight. Every one of these young men and women have excelled in their lives and academic performances to attain the right to be here this evening to receive their high school diplomas. Dr. Hager, Dr. Welch, President Loring, members of the Washoe County Board of Trustees, tonight it gives me great privilege to present to you the Galena High School graduating class of 2000 for the awarding of their diplomas.
Megan Lund.
Lisa Kapczynski.
Christopher Martindale.
Daniel Hickman.
Andrew Sweat.
Alexis Lee Scott.
Michael Ames.
Andrew Abris.
Michelle Rands.
Elizabeth England.
Jared Singleton.
Melanie Acton.
Jennifer Atkinson.
Ryan Alvey.
Diane Berent.
Jeffrey Artis. Hamilton Ashworth.
Lindy Bradstreet.
Matthew Atkinson.
Kimberly Dawn Brennan.
Michael Atkinson.
Nicole Teresa Bush.
Brian Baker.
Brittany Barnett.
David Barb.
Jessica Lynn Botts.
Leandro Basalo.
Rachel Lorraine Blinn.
Ryan Beeler.
Yvette Marie Bullard.
Jared Bahari.
Jolene Leslie Bye.
Allie Banaud.
Kendall Braun.
Paul Benton.
Ruth Kacharis.
Kevin Bryan.
Zara Cahill.
Christopher Black.
Christy Carew.
George Burby.
Cassia Joe Chevalon.
Anton Burton.
Jerrion Michelle Champ.
Anthony Bush.
Christine Chamberlain.
Eric Campbell.
Angelina Chambly.
Sean Carter.
Andrea Chiriboga.
Matthew Cheney Lampson.
Nikki Colthorpe.
Matthew Clark.
Jenna Nicole Correa.
Tappan Kornmesser.
Christina Corona.
Nathan Collingham.
Courtney Couch.
Ben Coyle.
Elizabeth Crozier.
Sean Cheatham.
Jamie Daly.
Devin Connell.
Anna DiArietta.
Ryan Cox.
Yeah. Stephanie Delano.
Justin Crowell.
Jacqueline Delgado.
Kevin Crawford.
Catherine Dickey.
Michael DiTullio.
Monica Deep.
Charles Driver.
Jennifer Diggs.
Corey Dayton.
Trelane Elizabeth Downs.
Mark Dieter.
Kirsten Drury.
James Dugan. Darren Elmore.
Megan Holly Eisman.
Michael Eldridge.
Courtney Ellis.
Zachary Fleming.
Mary Lou Etcheberry.
Travis Felker.
Laura Danielle Echito.
Carlos Flores.
Rebecca Evans.
David Fox.
Heather Farron.
Michael Friend.
Clara Fisher.
Philip Felder.
Carolyn Forsman.
Aaron Gross.
Erica Frank.
Jesse Garcia.
Christine Fujita.
Michael Gardner.
Diana Mary Guerra.
Sean Hallgren.
Trisha Gossi.
Jared Harker.
Morgan Green.
Ted Hammerly.
Julia Gritton.
Michael Hoffensberger.
Destiny Gill.
Milan Henninger.
Kelly Gunderson.
Aaron Hess.
Mariella Gonzalez.
Sean Holbrook.
Sarah Donnell Gutke.
Nathan Howell.
Shauna Hansen.
Kevin Hill.
Kathleen Hart.
Jonathan Isbell.
Marie Hedrick.
Adam Johnson.
Amanda Michelle Heineman.
Benjamin Johnson.
Jennifer Henderson.
Seth Johnson. Jesse Jones.
Heidi Hoff.
Michael Carl Jones.
Melissa May Hopkins.
Michael Christopher Jones.
Jacqueline Wu.
Jeremy Kingsbury.
Emily Deborah Hurdle.
Eric Kathman.
Aaron Brianne Iverson.
Brandon Kraus.
Rachel Jersey.
Daniel Knox.
Kira Johnson.
Justin Kamen.
Megan Jones.
Nakia Kanakoa.
Shannon Marie Kiefer.
Chad Koslowski.
Shauna Jane Kibbe.
Lance King.
Megan Kiriazzi. Ricky Liu.
Audra Penistet. Tiffany Michael Christie.
Bradley Lundin.
Jolene Kropp. Laura Marie Kruger.
Kern Ma.
Krueger.
Trevor Mackesy.
Rebecca Marie Lacey.
Nathan McClellan.
Erica Lajani.
Timothy Martin.
Brandy Larson.
Steve Mason.
Jessica Lance.
Justin Mezra.
Vanessa Latino.
Martin Metz.
Carla Linares.
Russell Miller.
Rebecca Leanne Lesh.
Mark Miller.
Asia Luares.
Micah Minaberry.
Marcy Michelle Marisfield.
Kevin Monahan.
Megan Mantell.
Christopher Morrison.
Janelle Mack.
William McMorrin.
Heather Martinez. Allison Markham.
Charles Morton.
Vanessa Martin.
Joel Nelson.
Jessica Martin Yuke.
Patrick Knorr.
Megan Leah McCumber.
Ryan Hauser.
Bridget Mead.
Casey Palilik.
Sarah Jennings Mills.
Josh Paradis.
Erica Mejia.
Joseph Perazzo Modlin.
Marisol Morales.
Stephen Parker.
Cheryl Mortensen.
Nathan Pazik.
Jessica Mullen.
Philip Fu.
Monica Marie Miles.
Jacob Rufus.
Tylene Joy Nierman.
Jessica Ober.
Ryan Ritter.
Nicole Ogle.
Matthew Sikora.
Dominique Oliveras.
Ryan Staggs.
Carla Oriana. Stephanie Ormsby.
Louis Sames.
Ginger Papard. Christine Zoe Pittman. Yeah. Lynn Pike.
T.R. Spriggs.
Celine Pichetti.
DJ Stacy.
Jennifer Perry.
Tristan Thomas Stiles.
Jennifer Peterson. Nicole Pascal.
Sam Talai.
Katrina Peters. Stacy Peterson.
Jeffrey Ermston.
Marissa Pendle.
Joseph Michael Young.
Cassandra Quinn.
Derek Wahlberg.
Allison Neva Rains.
David Welge.
Ivana Redlin.
Michael Witkowski Jr.
Amy Nicole Reed.
David White.
April Reed. Angela Ritchie.
James White.
Rita Christina Rumler. Guadalupe Rodriguez.
Christopher Weathers.
Reagan Rodriguez. I'm sorry.
Jeremy Wilts.
Jonathan Ripley.
Travis Wise.
Claire Ann Ruckman. Emily Rhine.
Kimberly Ann Ziegler.
Katie Richards.
Kelly Sheberl.
Carrie Lee Slosher.
Marcella Rose Shoto.
Julie Ann Simon. Michelle Squire.
Marquette Marie Stevens.
April Stevens.
Lisa Stevens.
Destiny Stewart.
Kristen Stockwell.
Jessica Lee Surrett.
Dawn Marie.
Brianne Swanson.
Jamie Taylor.
Kimberly Taylor. Melinda Thomas.
Jessica Thompson.
Carla Thorkelson. Shannon Thornton.
Tatiana Tibbetawiza.
Cynthia Torres. Angela Volk.
Ashley Vieira.
Christina Vogel.
Jessica Vieira.
Emily Whitney Williams.
Rebecca Woolridge.
And the final graduate of the class of 2000, April Zumhoff.
In addition to our graduates, we would like to recognize our 7 senior foreign exchange students. Would the 7 of you please stand up and be recognized?
Ladies and gentlemen, following our ceremony this evening after we graduate the class, and as part of the celebration, we have a special indoor firework display that has been pre-approved and pre-arranged by the Fire Marshal and Lawler Event Center. For those of you who may have young children in the audience tonight, or for those of you who may have elderly grandparents or relatives with you, if you will please help them to understand that at the end of this ceremony, there will be some bright bursts and some loud pops, but everything is okay and safe, and we wish you a great celebration.
Will the class please rise? I'd like to officially proclaim you as now being graduated. Congratulations.
Our school years are almost over.
It's amazing to think of all the great memories we've had from our days at school.
Like my first crush.
Yeah, I met my first high school boyfriend freshman year, and amazingly, we're still together.
Yeah, I remember my first fight in elementary school and my first trip to the principal's office.
Yeah, I remember my first car. It was great when it ran.
I remember my first job in an ice cream joint. Man, I still smell like ice cream.
Weren't those great memories?
The thing I'm going to miss most about Galena is going out with my friends, going to the beach to have barbecues, having fun, just hanging out.
Am I going to miss from Galena? Probably mostly all the friends that you earn while you're here, and like all the sports and everything. You meet a lot of new people and just basically earning people's trust.
I think the best thing about Galena High School is my friends and lunchtime.
That's easy. Teasing Mrs. Greenall and making fun of her every day would have to go down as the best thing about being here. All the different types of assignments that I had here. I know a lot of people don't like doing work, but I don't know, I tried to have fun with it and be creative and have a sense of humor about it. And I got an opportunity to show that with a lot of my teachers.
My best senior memory is last year when I think during the Reno game when Tim Martin kind of missed a punt and ran backwards, you know, to kind of score points for the other team.
One of my funniest moments definitely has to be when Megan Mantell got hit with a basketball during one of our basketball games.
My memory was hitting a home run with Ricky Woodring's bat, the first game I used it, my junior year. And what I'm going to do now is go play baseball in college.
And what I'm going to miss most is the football games.
What I miss most about Galena is playing sports like softball, because I've met a lot of really cool people, and I'll miss the coaches and traveling. That's about it. The thing I'm going to miss most about Galena High School is all the teachers.
And my favorite teacher is Miss Mattioni. And Miss Blakely's right up in the runnings with that, too.
Well, I don't have a favorite teacher, really. I like Mr. Wright because he teaches off campus and I can read.
Mr. Hauser. Can't go wrong with Mr. Hauser. I think he's, I hope I still graduate after saying this, but Hauser's the best.
Miss Lindsay. Why? Because she's very tolerant.
The message I would like to leave is meet as many girls as you can, because you can never have enough girls.
Have fun and just like, it's going to be over really quickly, so do everything you can so you won't have any regrets.
My quote to the senior class is go big or go home.
To all of my favorite seniors, good luck.
Being at Galena the last 4 years has taught me a lot about remaining open and receptive to new things at all times, and learning this, I feel, will be important for the rest of my life.
Jay, I'll miss you guys. I love you.
It's all about the memories.
Thank you.
I never felt this time of my life. No, I never felt this way before.
Never felt.
Yes, I swear it's the truth, and I hope it'll take you.
Have it. That's all, folks.